are, you do freelance video, and you set up a nationwide boycott of BP? You just wake up one day, feel that that was your calling?
It kind of was. I was watching the news, and I was upset about what was going on, and I just started a Facebook page, Boycott BP, and it just took off.
So you were not an environmentalist before? Recycle?
I would do some recycling, and I was aware of it. I have compact fluorescence, you know, and things like that. I don't use anything extra, but I would hardly say I was like a Ed Begley Jr. or something.
Welcome to my house!
I made it as energy efficient as I could. I got my solar oven.
I would say I was pretty much just an average American with some concern for the environment. Now I'm seeing the error of my ways.
Are people doing it? Are people signing on and boycotting?
They are, and we get reports from all over that they see the BP stations are empty and ARCO stations are empty. It's amazing to me that it's working.
Have you heard anything from BP?
Nothing, not a word. And, but I think they read my stuff. I'll put it to you like that. And
why do you think that?
Well, I think that they're monitoring the whole situation to get a feel for what's going on, and this is a way for people to sound off, you know, the Boycott BP website is.
But if they boycott BP, is there a risk that BP can't pay what they need to pay?
I've heard that before, but I think they've got assets that they can, they have plenty of assets. I think they're making somewhere between $60 and $70 million a day. They've got plenty of money. They're what, third, fourth largest corporation in the world?
Fourth, I think, yeah.
Yeah, so they're plenty big.
What's the next thing you're going to do with this page?
I've got 600,000 bosses telling me what to do, so I listen as much as I can. The crazy thing is just asking people to buy gasoline someplace else has raised so much anger out of a lot of people. It's like you're attacking their best friend or something, and you're like, it's just a gas station. You can go to another one and buy gasoline, it's, you know, and
but aren't you just hurting the gas station franchise owner? I mean, are you really hurting the company that much?
I mean, the fishermen down here, they've been hurt. They've lost their jobs perhaps 10 years, 5, 10 years, maybe forever. And the franchise owners, they can rebrand the station, you know. I don't think that after this happens, anybody in the South or the Gulf South at the minimum is going to want to see a BP sign.
If you could have them do one thing, what would you want them to do?
Stop the leak, first and foremost.
Well, they're trying, right?
Trying as hard as they can. I guess the other thing that they could do is provide for the fishermen down South. They've given them, you know, one or two checks, but I don't think that they're compensating them fully for what they've lost. Also, I think, you know, the tourism industry obviously has been suffering and will suffer, and they're going to have to compensate those people, too, that work, the waiters, the busboys, the bartenders, all the people that work in the lodging industry are going to be without jobs. And that's my answer for the franchise owners that are upset, too, is that, you know, we've lost our jobs down here, too. BP should be compensating us for that.